Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification to receive the regular dose of positivity. Thank you. Hey guys, this is Huzaifa from my YouTube channel Positive Academy. In today's video, I am going to share some of the steps which helps you to become rich. So first is time management, how to work harder and smarter. Well guys, we all have 24 hours a day. How you utilize this 24 hours is very important. Today we are the result. Today is what we are, the result of our past deeds, and in the future we will be the result of all the deeds which we are doing in the present. Remember, I am not going to show you some shortcut, but it is definitely a shortcut. Is you need to work harder and smarter, and time management is the thing. So every human being on this planet has 24 hours a day. Now how he or she utilizes this 24 hours plays a very crucial role. Lot of people spend time right in doing the activities which leads them to the waste of time, such as checking messages on WhatsApp, Facebook and other things. That you need to focus on some of the activities which will give you 80% result while working just 20%, and other looking for 80% working and 20% results is just 80-20 principle. In that way you can substitute your time. And today what you are is the result of all the past deeds or past actions that you have taken, and in the future you will be result of all those actions which you are now taking today, right, to become your greatest version. I am in this video not going to show something like a shortcut, but it is definitely a shortcut, right? So for that to begin, you need to make a use of your phone as a gadget. You need to set an alarm, right? And just by doing this for 30 minutes, you can just progress or monitor what are your things which you are doing in the next past 30 minutes. In that way, you will be able to get a conscious ideas about time management, how you spend your time. And you will realize that in the past 30 minutes, you have done nothing special, but you have just wasted the time. So in that way, you will become more conscious about time management. And time management is the first thing you need to take care if you want to be successful, if you want to be rich. Peace. Hey guys, the second step I am talking about is learn from the mistakes and be committed. Now, a lot of people just think that they went from failure, right? They are suffering from failure, but they blame others for that, right? When you blame others, you are not having control on your life, but you are giving the control to some others. But when you take 100% responsible for each and everything that happens in your life, you are having the control on your life, right? Look at the celebrities and the sports personality. They don't have any excuse or mood for any scheduled event that they are planning, right? For example, take celebrity, they are planning their things, right, just before 2 years, right? And whatever happens on that day, they will not give an excuse, but they will be committed to make that thing happen, right? So commitment must be there, right? And you need to learn from your mistake. What mistakes help us to know that you need to be alerted, you need to not do that thing which results into failure. And if you are suffering from failure and you are not getting again up, then it is your mistake, not others' mistake, right? So that's the second point. The next step I am talking is achieve personal growth and professional development. Now, they both are interlinked to each other. When you spend 10,000 or plus more hours to anything, you become a genius in that particular thing. Now, if you don't have any skills or if you are lacking somewhere, you need to learn that skills. Now, just I am making this video doesn't mean that I am doing this particular stuff. But I am gaining expertise in so many different areas that it will support this
all the other areas will support me to become this, the content creator which I am, right? For example, take example of Cristiano Ronaldo. Now he's an expert in football expert. He started to play football when he was at the age of 6 and continue right till the age of 16, right? And now he has become so much expert that he is well known for that particular thing. So if you want to be an expert for any particular thing, you need to give that time. Time is the most crucial thing. You need to spend time on that, and then when you become an expert, you can earn money. And there is no need to earn money, no need to ask for something. Automatically, when you become an expert in something, people will come to you and you will become the thing which you wanted. I already told before that lifelong learning is the key. You need to learn each and every day. You need to upgrade yourself. If you are not upgrading yourself, you are lacking somewhere or other. So if you are not knowing some stuff, try to learn that each and every day. In that way, you are adding more expertise and skill to yourself. And when you are having more skills, you can develop that or turn into that income source, right? Next step I'm talking is how to budget your money. Every person must know the incoming and outgoing of money. Whenever he or she just gets out from the home place, he or she must know how much money he or she is having. And at the night time when he is back at the home, he must know how much he have added that money or have lost that money. By the way, if you are watching this video, do you know how much money you are having in the pocket? I recommend you check that. Next, so much people are just wasting their time over the emotions. There are two things people must focus on. First is needs, another is emotion. Needs is a thing which you are having a requirement, and emotions are the thing. Suppose a company is having an offer of 80% and you wish that, okay, there is an offer going 8%, let's buy it. But you are not having that need for it. You are buying because you are having an offer of 80%. So that's the difference between need and emotions. And if you are playing safe, right, if you control your needs, your emotions, you will be on the safer side. And each and every person needs to keep an account of the money of incoming and outgoing every day. And you need to divide that money in different categories. You need to make your budget, make your financial incoming and outgoing. The next step I am talking about is money saving and investing. Now, you need to invest into asset which will give you some return. Do not invest into liabilities. For example, you are looking for a phone. Do not go for an iPhone of 55,000 or something cost. Now, even if you keep an iPhone into your cupboard or something and you keep out after 7 days, its value will decrease. You will eventually get 50,000 or something. Instead, you need to invest that 50. You need to spend less money, about 15,000, and remaining other money you need to invest into something which will give you return. You can go for property, you can go for commodity, you can go for insurance, FD, bonds, mutual fund, right? And if you invest early, you can get early returns. Save money, try to save money, do not waste money. You can have a pen of 15 rupees also, and you can go for 1000 rupees pen also. Just as 1000 rupees pen will look good, doesn't mean you need to spend that 1000 rupees money. Go for just 15 rupees money. Right, try to save money and invest as early as possible. If you invest early, there is a chances of getting into a great return. Do not invest into depreciation. Do not invest into liabilities which will eventually lead into depreciation. Right, go for something which you can get returns. The next point I am talking about is do not believe in discouraging people. People will definitely tell you that you won't be able to make it, this is not of your kind, right? And there are other things, they will demotivate you. But you don't need to listen to them. Instead, you need to focus on yourself to become the greatest person. Let me give you an example, right? There is a group of frogs, right? While they were just walking around, they fell into some well. and few of them were on the upper side of the well, and rest about 4 or 5 just fell into the well. So the other people were saying, the other frogs were saying them that they will not be able to get out of that well. Now they need to stay in that well only, right? And all of them all of a sudden were following, were trying to get out, right? And for example, he just stopped doing that task for few minutes, then B stopped thinking, okay, we won't be able to make it. Then C does the same. D, after trying for some time, just left the hope. Now the frog E, right, he tried. The people, the frog which were above the well, were just saying that don't go for it, don't make it, you will not able to make it. But he was just trying, and all of the sudden he just came out of the well, right? And there were other frogs were surprised how he will be able to make it. But that E frog was deaf. He is not able to listen. He was not listening what others are saying. In fact, he thought that they are encouraging them that you can make it, you can do it, you are confident, you will be able to do it, right? So let go of all the people that no longer serve in your life, that discourage you, that demotivate you. Let go of all them. Guys, the next step I'm talking is be generous. Now you need to have that abundance mindset. Universe is in abundance. There is nothing I am lacking with. There is always abundant in my life. You need to appreciate each and everything which you are having. You need to be grateful. Now I'm not just saying that when money comes you need to just spend on it, or you need to donate or something like that. But I'm also telling that sharing is caring, right? You can share that with other things, like just self-made millionaires and billionaires are sharing their things to other people, right? And when you help, sharing can be in terms of help or giving some support or something to other people, right? If you are liking this video, you can also share to others. In that way you are caring for others, and this is the part of generous thing, right? So appreciate each and everything which you are having in your life, and when you are emitting positive energy, universe will definitely give you more positive thing. And when you are into a negative thing or some egos, envy, jealousy kind of thing, then universe will invest that more into you. So I hope you are enjoying this content. If you are new, consider subscribing, and it would be great if you like and share the video. See you in the next video. Till then, bye, peace.